is a great way to work on end range hip abduction strength. We are going to work on a little bit of mobility here, which translates into better control and strength in a lot of different exercises. We're really working to train the outer glute or side butt stuff. There's three options and lots of options in between, but I'm going to show you three options today and you can modify this to your liking. You're going to want to make sure you either are up against a squat rack, something stationary like a bench, or a wall so that you're not leaning, because that's cheating and we're not cheating here. This would be the easiest position. Forward onto our hands in the quadruped position. We're gonna inhale, trap air into our abdomen, find the outer glute stuff, contract it like we're trying to make our foot light on the ground, contract that harder like we're turning a dial up on a volume dial, and then float the leg up and hold for the predetermined amount of time. And then we're gonna parachute that leg back down. If you get cramps, try to work on it. That is something that should go away once we get better control. What we are looking to avoid is shoving our body into this and just trying to use momentum to push our leg up as fast as possible. That would be the easiest position. The next hardest is going to be collapsed with your butt glued to your heel, and the same exact thing is gonna happen. We are inhaling, finding outer glute stuff, floating the leg up, holding, and parachuting it back down, making sure that our hamstrings glued to our calf the entire time. The next hardest, near impossible position is going to be a collapsed foot. So my laces are gonna be on the ground, my butt into my heel, and we're gonna do the exact same thing here. Inhale, try to lift, and hold for the predetermined amount of time without coming forward and without leaning into this. I want you to find the position that requires your max concentration. It's really hard, but you can still achieve success.